Well, hi there, Internet. My name's Court, and you've got courtside seats for my review of the brand new video on demand movie, The Haunting of Sharon Tate. Let's do it. I guess. The Haunting of Sharon Tate is a drama horror thriller from director Daniel Farrands and Lionsgate. The movie stars Hilary Duff, Jonathan Bennett, Lydia Hearst, Pawel Szajda, and Ryan Cargill. Pregnant with director Roman Polanski's child and awaiting his return from Europe, 26-year-old Hollywood actress Sharon Tate becomes plagued by visions of her imminent death. I'm gonna keep this short, and it's mostly gonna be off the top of my head, because I hated this movie. So it's like a home invasion movie with some sort of suggested supernatural elements, but of course it's based off the real life massacre of these people, so it already feels a little bit exploitative and a little bit icky. And I don't know what this movie's trying to be. I guess it's a horror movie, but it's not, like, scary at all. Yeah, it's got some jump scares, but they're all telegraphed so hard that you see them coming a mile away anyway. And the dialogue is horrible. It's filled with, like, cliched platitudes all the time. There's a moment where one character says to Sharon Tate, "For you, Sharon, I think your life is turning out just the way you want it to," or something like that. But we know from, you know, history that Sharon Tate died, and foreshadowing doesn't work when you know the actual ending. And Hilary Duff is trying her best here, but it just really doesn't work. I think part of it is that she's just straight up miscast, but she was also a producer on the movie, so there's that. And also, again, because the dialogue is so bad, even an amazing actress couldn't have done much with it. Now, as much as Hilary Duff is trying, some of the other people in the movie are not. There is one guy, one character in the movie who was so bad, every line he spoke had me laughing. And it wasn't just because the lines were written poorly, it was because of his delivery. It was like The Room bad, and I'm not exaggerating. And throughout the film, Sharon Tate has visions of what's going to happen. So then in the climax, when those things are happening, it feels like a retread because we've already seen them once or twice before. And there was a moment in the climax where I laughed out loud. I'm sure that was not the desired response. And then the ending. Oh my goodness gracious me, the ending. So they pull this bait and switch, then they pull it again, and then they pull it again just for good measure. And you know the filmmaker's sitting there in the editing bay like, oh, I'm gonna blow people's minds now. But you know exactly what's going on. These people are walking, and we know totally what's happening, and then the music is swelling, and it's going to slow-mo, like it's building to this big reveal that, like, you were aware of 2 minutes before they even get there. So when it happens, you're just like, yeah, I know. Honestly, this movie is a 90-minute eye roll, and I really don't recommend it. However, I will say, it's pretty well shot. Now, I don't have a proprietary rating system as of yet, so I'm just trying to figure out what I'm gonna give The Haunting of Sharon Tate, and I think I'm gonna give The Haunting of Sharon Tate a out of 10. So now I want to know, have you seen The Haunting of Sharon Tate? What did you think about it? What's your favorite, I don't know, Hilary Duff song of all time? Whatever your thoughts, hit the comments below. Let's discuss. If you enjoyed this review, please smash that like button and give it a share if you really enjoyed it. And hey, why not take a second, do me a favor, click subscribe and ring that bell to subscribe to my channel for more movie reviews, entertainment news, trailer reactions, all that good stuff. Thanks very much for watching. See you guys in the next one. I hope it's a better one. Take care.